But let's get back to MLW, man. So I think the report is going around that these guys want to partner with WWE, vice versa, something like that. So thoughts on this one?
Yes, so it was as part of the latest Observer from Big Dave himself that it starts off as, and it's largely a speculation in the grand scheme of things, that it was addressed initially as WWE is kind of pissed that they're not working with any other promotions in USA as part of, helping exchange talent and stuff. So they are in talks with MLW. And speaking of, again, just to slightly divert it, MLW also got a recent TV deal. So they were having shows on beIN Sports, which is one of the big sports networks in US and elsewhere. It's originally from Qatar. So from there, they are moving to Vice TV, which is also the home for Dark Side of the Ring, which is a highly acclaimed documentary that airs on Vice. So that's there. And this whole premise, the whole premise of the WWE and MLW partnership is to let, the stars who aren't being used or any performance center recruits can get some exposure and some TV time over there. So it's kind of like what ECW was doing in the 90s during the Monday Night Wars, taking some of the WWE undercard talent and, giving them exposure and TV time. So that's something. And it's fine with me because, again, there are the NXT talent pool is bloated right now. And a lot of these guys could get some exposure over there. Like, kind of like what ECW was in 2006-2007, as like underused talent can go there, get like a refreshing outlook on things, and once they are back a slightly little relevant, they can jump back into the scene on either on SmackDown. So this is the case with NXT and MLW, but I feel this was something that they wanted to do with Evolve in the beginning.
So what's the deal with Evolve now? Is it completely dissolved with WWE?
I think it is, but the last rumors are to be recalled. They were trying to make a show for Evolve on the network, which was, again, it was trying to serve the same purpose as giving wrestlers training on, of the how the TV works with the hard cam and stuff, and getting them to wrestle and then graduating them on to the NXT main show.
So on the topic of this partnership here, so do you think you said you they could send the guys that are not being used to MLW? Do you think will it fit only for NXT or the entire WWE?
It will be so much better if the entire WWE was involved, but the level of programming that is there, I think it only befits NXT for now. Maybe later, if this partnership is successful, which we hope so, then we can see a lot of underused talents on the main roster to go there and do something meaningful. But I don't want to say main concern over here, but MLW currently is also in partnership with AAA in Mexico, as well as if Filthy Tom Lawler is counted. So if WWE is there, maybe they'll just be as usual, they are the alphas every time. So it's still a little confusing to me how the entire spectrum will work out. But if this is a thing, if the partnership does go through, then I think it's good for both the parties involved.
And back to my question, I think that this will only be open for NXT and not for the main roster, because think about it, man. If people, we have people over on the main roster, they always want, send me back to NXT. But, the higher ups don't give them that permission. So how do you expect them to, expect these people to go over in MLW if they can't even go to NXT?
NXT. That's, yeah, that's what it is. And yeah, like I mentioned earlier, it's just going to benefit NXT and the performance center recruits. But to put it conclusively, like, this is still a speculation at the end of the day. Do you think it's going to go through, or do you think we might see something out of it?
I think WWE wants to jump on the bandwagon, you know. AEW is doing a partnership with everyone, so I think they also want some Forbidden partnership Door. Too.
Forbidden Door. And I just realized, like, last year, like, not last year, like, when during the initial year of AEW, 2019, 2020 apart, at that time, they were the ones who were working with AEW and AAA. So it will be a little funny to see WWE filling that slot by AEW.
And now that I think of it, I think this is not the first time, you know, in the modern era that WWE has worked with someone else. If you think about it, I think once there was a time, you know, they got Jushin Liger for NXT. Remember that?
Yes, that was just one-off. And Jushin Liger is a freelancer, so...
And, you know, they also sent Hideo Itami at the time to Pro Wrestling Noah.
Noah, yes.
So,
I
won't be surprised, you know, if they pull out this MLW deal too.
Yeah, but most of those were one-offs. And they were in a different country altogether. So, and again, speaking of working with promotions abroad, the whole NXT UK situation and how they're recruiting talent for that, as well as for the promotion in Germany, WXW, that's also affiliated with WWE right now.
I think just like Evolve, they also will merge those into the WWE system too.
Yeah.
Basically, like they have killed the half of the, you know, UK scene.
They killed like 80 to 85% of it, because there are still like small indie promotions who are doing well for themselves. Like Riptide Wrestling is their one. So one of my mutuals on Twitter is helping them out. But now I think the whole UK scene is dead right now after the whole speaking out movement.
Anyways, man, let's see where this MLW deal goes. I would like to see, you know, some of the talents go over there. Maybe some of the talents come over here.